In September of this year, the South Korean TV series Squid Game was released on the Netflix streaming service. The series conveys a story in a setting of deadly games for money. Leading the top series in 90 countries, the series blew up the media space, becoming the most popular and discussed in the world. Many immediately rushed to praise the series for its vivid anti-capitalist propaganda. The story is about people with multi-million dollar debts who are being terrorized by collectors and dream of getting miraculously rich. Undoubtedly, it was bound to succeed from the very beginning. In fact, the script wasn't demanded for a long time until a large American film company paid attention to the promising director in 2019. South Korean film director Hwang Dong-hyuk, who has successful films in both his native country and Asia as a whole, created the concept and script for the series. The author had the idea and the draft version of the script ready for a long time. As he said in an interview, his source of inspiration was his own financial situation during the financial crisis of 2008. When he was a young man, he and his family were experiencing serious financial hardship. According to Hwang, he had the idea for the movie back then. Proceeding from a number of Japanese type of comics, manga, Hwang Dong-hyuk was obsessed with creating a survival games movie with local specifics. As the director later admitted to The Hollywood Reporter, at that moment, he himself would have gladly joined such a game to get out of his terrible situation. The series follows people who find themselves in a difficult financial situation. In addition to unemployment, low wages, and general poverty, multi-million dollar debt obligations hang on each of them. As a result, they suffer the terror of collectors and have to think about tomorrow with horror. The main character, Song Gi-hun, is just one of these characters. In the past, a bankrupt entrepreneur, a failed taxi driver, and now an avid gambler living on his mother's money. Furthermore, he suffers from the visits of collectors, not unlike street bandits. Moreover, just like everyone else, he lives the dream of suddenly becoming rich and completely forgetting about his debts. Therefore, he wastes any free money on betting and cannot buy a gift for his daughter, who lives with the character's ex-wife. One day, a strapping young man in a suit meets him on the subway, who first offers to play a simple game for a large sum and then invites him to take part in a much larger game. The game that will allow him to win a lot of money, enough to forever forget about poverty and get a new life. The main character decided not to give up a chance that could turn his whole life around. The character accepts the offer. Upon arriving at the appointed place, he gets into a truck and leaves in an unknown direction. From there, he gets to a mysterious island. Thus, hundreds of people are in one place at the same time. Yesterday, they were counting every penny, and today, they're taking part in a game, and the prize is a new life. The dream has come true. After signing the agreement with the rules of the game, it begins. Already at the first game, it turns out that the price of defeat is real and cruel death. Despite the seemingly harmless children's games, for violating their rules or losing, soldiers in pink suits immediately kill unsuccessful players. Each death increases the final prize pool, which consists of the debts of each of the deceased players. Shocked by what happened, the survivors decide to use the third rule and initiate a vote on the completion of the first round of the games. After voting with a slight margin by one vote, the organizers finish the games and take people home, prudently leaving the opportunity to return at any time. However, a person who has to choose between starvation and a deadly game does not really have any choice. Since the players are not economically free, the game will continue in any case, and the democratic process, in the form of the freedom to stop and resume the game, is nothing more than a screen, and in fact, does not affect anything, as the organizers well know. Ultimately, the games continue. Dozens of people perish by failing tasks. Players split into teams, negotiate, betray, and kill one another when they realize that it's advantageous. Real capitalists behave similarly to the masters of the game, simulating competition among workers and forcing them to fight with each other for jobs. At the same time, the political rights and opportunities of workers, which bourgeois democracy provides them, are strictly limited and reduced to the right to elect representatives of the ruling class to public positions every few years, while maintaining the existing economic system. In general, it looks like a game, but in real life. In numerous interviews, Hwang Dong-hyuk has repeatedly stressed that his story is based on the class struggle, and he wanted to create an anti-capitalist satire. Indeed, Squid Game has a number of advantages in depicting the vices of capitalist society. It was his topical, familiar story about debt and inequality in every corner of the world that made him so popular. Every worker, whether Korean, Chinese, European, or American, lives in fear of being evicted or killed because of debt. This fear is not figurative and not a fantasy. It is stronger than any cataclysm, cosmic invasion, or awakening of ancient evil. The fear of being on the street, without food and warmth, at the lowest level of society, having lost any opportunity to experience simple human happiness, to lose a family or close relatives. The author was able to reveal the psychology of a man mired in debt. During the voting on the termination of the games, in response to panicked requests to vote against the game, one of the characters asks a simple question, "Who needs us?" Through her mouth, the screenwriter tells the truth. For people driven into extreme need, physical death is no longer so terrible. The fear of a commoner bound by debt bondage, as well as their dreams of liberation from it, it does not have a narrow national or cultural framework. It is the universal fear and the universal dream of all working people of the world. This shows the global nature of capitalism. By creating a global, common market for all, capital has created a global, common culture for all. It is extremely significant that the work about the problems of traditionally Western society was created in Asia. There is practically nothing left of the once technological backwardness and cultural isolation. Now, it is the same capitalist world, which repeats the history and path of the classical capitalist countries, one by one. Despite the exotic language and appearance of the characters, they live with the same problems of the so-called Western world. Poor and rich, inequality, and class antagonism are also present among them, not imported, but grown on their own soil, integrated into the world market. Drowning in debt, overexploitation, the power of corporations and the rampant military, suppressing protests and mass strikes. There is an episode in the series in which Song Gi-hun recalls how his friend died during the dispersal of a strike. Squid Game clearly shows that there is no third, special way. The development of capitalist relations, no matter how you combine them with traditions and spirituality, with some national ideas, always generate the same thing. The same disenfranchisement and oppression without distinction of language and faith. Even the games themselves do not exist as an isolated plot. Super rich anonymous people from Europe and America watch the deadly games. Meanwhile, the games are not only in Korea, but also in other countries. However, with all the advantages of the series and its obvious anti-capitalist message, Squid Game is not something unique. History knows many examples of bourgeois art attacking capitalism with damning criticism. There are dozens of literary works of the 19th and early 20th centuries, created by bourgeois writers, as well as many films and TV series of our days, shot over the past 30 to 40 years. James Cameron's Avatar, films from the cyberpunk genre, Blade Runner, Judge Dredd, Total Recall, Parasite in 2019, also created in South Korea. There are many more examples. Although all these films often tell about fictional people and fictional worlds, they reflect our own world and have an important agitational value. The author of Squid Game showed horrifying pictures of poverty and disenfranchisement of workers under capitalism. Therefore, the first place in the Netflix world ranking only confirms how truthful, close, and familiar they are to the masses of millions. However, just like its predecessors, the brainchild of Hwang Dong-hyuk suffers from the natural limitations of bourgeois art, which is unable to go beyond demonstrating the problems of modern society. It does not offer ways to solve them, and does not question the foundations of capitalist society in the form of private property and exploitation of man by man. Song Gi-hun made a long, 9-part journey. He tried to respond to every challenge, every test of humanity, with compassion, mutual assistance, and altruism. As a character, he has undergone development. In the first episode, we meet an egotistical gambler who begs for money from an elderly mother to squander it on his next bets. He has no money left, even to buy a gift for his daughter. At the end of the series, we have a character who has passed through trials and hardened by difficulties. A man who is determined to embark on the path of fighting the organizers of the deadly games. this is exactly what a manifestation of bourgeois narrow-mindedness is. Instead of trying to destroy the economic relations that generate inequality in the deadly games, the main character wants to destroy only the games themselves. It does not fight with causes, but with consequences. Every class has its own philosophy, its own ideology. At the same time, philosophy preserves the principle of partisanship and carries those ideas that are beneficial to this class, reflecting its own worldview. A feature of the worldview of the exploiting class is their conviction in the eternity and inviolability of their own position. It is unacceptable for them to think about the finiteness or transitivity of the social system that raised them to the top of the social pyramid. In this spirit, the bourgeoisie, as a modern exploiting class, adjusts science, philosophy, and all humanitarian disciplines, subordinates arts to its general class will. Through this, capitalists are trying to spread a false belief in the eternity of market relations, eternities of division into rich and poor, winners and losers. Existing in a world torn apart by class contradictions, bourgeois science and art cannot remain passive. They have to respond to the movement of the masses of working people, having their own philosophy and class interests. However, they're always limited to meaningful compassion and, at a maximum, the demand for reforms due to their bourgeois nature. No matter how successful any modern work criticizing capitalism is, it simply cannot lead to a revolution in the minds of the masses, because it does not contain a revolutionary message and slides into simple moralizing. As is known, social being determines social consciousness. No matter how much one talks about humanity and compassion, if economic conditions push a person into poverty and question their survival, will become bestial and commit the most immoral of acts. Therefore, if you want to change the behavior or qualities of people for the better, you need to change the conditions in which they live. The problems of modern society are rooted in the economic soil, in the presence of exploitation of man by man, the contradiction between the public nature of production and the private form of the appropriation of the results of this production, and the way to solve them is to unite the workers and collective struggle for their class interests. Only with the victory of socialism and the elimination of all exploitation of labor, both direct and indirect, will a new just society become possible. A society in which debt bondage and deadly games for the amusement of the rich are simply unthinkable, in which there is no need to think about survival, but it is enough to show the desire and the desire to work in order to get a decent life. Stay tuned.